Okay, today we have Mr. Howard Spiva, who's our speaker for today. He's a trial attorney who began his law practice over 30 years ago. He's known as a kids lawyer for his work as founder and executive director of the Justice for Children Foundation, protecting children one helmet at a time. He is affiliated with the Southern Trial Lawyers Association, Georgia Trial Lawyers Association, and Savannah Trial Lawyers Association. He attended Chatham County Public Schools and Savannah State University. He graduated from Armstrong State University. He has multiple belts in martial arts, and his wife's name is Kelly. They reside in Savannah, Georgia, and they have two sons, Clay and Jean. So I present to you Mr. Attorney Howard E. Spiva.
I'm honored the opportunity to attend y'all's parent university and talk to you about children's safety. How many of you were in the main breakout room earlier? Okay, I'll try not to cover the same ground, but I do want to emphasize a couple of things. I do serious catastrophic injuries, and over the years, we've handled a lot of cases involving children. And our belief is that children's injuries are no accident. And that is that if something happens to a child, somewhere something wasn't done correctly or someone didn't do something they were supposed to do. And we realized this whenever we put together the pictures of all the children we've represented about 15, 16 years ago, after I've been practicing for about 15 years. And another thing that we did, well, we formed the Justice for Children Foundation. We have a lot of volunteers, we have board members, and we're really serious about spreading education and preventing traumatic brain injuries. And I do radio shows all over the country. I've spoken nationally a couple hundred times. And a lot of people will say, well, yeah, why don't we just bubble wrap our kids and, you know, not let them leave the house? And some people will say, yeah, but we don't need another law. Well, first of all, I'm not trying to get it mandated where kids have to wear helmets. I don't want parents to get tickets if their kids aren't wearing helmets, and I don't want the government being any more in our business. But what I do want to do is I want to make parents aware of a couple of facts. And even equally important is we want kids to know that helmets are cool. And there's a notebook back there on the table, and we pulled some pictures of Thor and Iron Man and the stormtroopers from Star Wars and
Paw Patrol.
Yeah. by the way, that's Crystal is our project program and event coordinator, and she works with us. And then Sabrina's my sister-in-law, and she's here volunteering. And Rosetta is here, and she works with us and is volunteering. And usually comes with Tweety Bird. I don't know what happened to Tweety Bird. I think he overslept this morning. Ed is back there, my wife Kelly. They mentioned that Kelly and I had two sons, Clay and Jean. They made it sound like we had two little toddlers. Clay's daughter is in college.
Oh, wow.
And his son just got his driver's license. Clay's a lawyer in our office. He's 40. Jean is in law school and he's 30. So, but we've been doing this a really long time. I know y'all have all seen some of the silly commercials on TV and so forth with lawyers, and they have hammers and they get on 18-wheelers and so forth. I get real frustrated with those guys, not because I have any problem with people trying to get business or if they want to look silly. But the problem is they don't really know what they're doing, and I've never seen any of those guys in 32 years in the courtroom. So what I did was I published a book this year. It's called Winning Your Case. It immediately went to 4 bestseller lists on Amazon, and it's 21 questions you must ask for hiring a lawyer. And this is not self-serving because I do only catastrophic injuries, children's brain injuries, tractor trailers, forklifts, stuff like that. Any of y'all heard about the case where the city didn't maintain their trees and a tree fell and a lady lost her leg and this jury gave $12 million? Well, that was our case. We have 3 of the highest verdicts in Savannah, 2 statewide highest verdicts, and also some of the highest settlements. And all we're trying to do is fix what they broke and, you know, not make anybody hit the lottery. And the problem that I've seen is that A lot of the lawyers out there don't really have the resources to do what we do. And so I published this book, and the reason I say it's not self-serving is it's not just for people for car wrecks. So what we're doing is, it sells on Amazon for like 20 bucks, but we're giving them away today. And if you would like to take it and look at it, there's a chapter in here that tells about justice for children. And it's 21 questions that if you have a dispute with a neighbor, you buy a house, if you got a parking ticket, if you got a speeding ticket, if you end up with a workers' comp injury or whatever, by the time you ask the lawyer these questions, you will know whether or not that lawyer knows what they're talking about or whether or not you want them. And then we threw in 22 bonus questions. I guess 43 questions just didn't sound good, so we called it 21 questions and had some bonus questions. But, and then we answered the questions ourselves to give you some ideas of why the questions. And for example, like say you ask the lawyer, you know, what's your reputation in the community? We have here 105 lawyers across the country that recommended our firm based on the coverage that we've done. So anyway, this will tell you about Justice for Children. It's free. If you know somebody that has a problem, needs a lawyer, give it to them. They can figure out. And then just call us and we'll give you another book. And if you know anyone that, we have vouchers. If you know anyone that doesn't have their child here, you can give them a voucher. They can come to our office. We'll fit them. We'll put them on our birthday card list. We'll let you know of any events. And so we'll keep you informed. But anyway, I've been doing this for 32 years, and when we realized that all these 30 or 40 pictures of children about 15, 16 years ago had preventable injuries. Now, the number one cause of injuries in children in wrecks is rear-ended, the back of the seat breaks. And we've been trying to get the auto industry to make the seats to where they don't break on just a mild rear-end collision. And the seat falls back. Before it was the back of the parent's head, now it's usually the headrest, smacks the child in the forehead, and all that is prevented by one of these plastic helmets. And we know that because the Center for Disease Control and the Pediatric Association says that the number one cause of traumatic brain injuries in children under 5, that means they're in child safety seats. That means they have a seatbelt on. It's in a car wreck. And it changed from bicycles because they mandated helmets. 75% of brain injuries went away, and 85% of deaths went away. And can you imagine the guilt of a parent that their seat breaks in a minor accident, nobody even goes to the emergency room, and the child has a fractured skull or subdural hematoma, like brain bleed or something like that, it could have been prevented. And so we don't want somebody to cause the helmets $49 at the bike shop or $29 at Target or $19 at Walmart. We don't want somebody to not make a financial decision. So we buy these and give them away. And we buy them in bulk, and huge bulk. And we've got two law firms now in Texas that have joined our ambassador program. As we develop our handbook, so to speak, we're going to get lawyers in every state. And eventually our goal is to get a lawyer in every city doing this across America. Because when we leave here today and the kids have the helmets, we don't know how many injuries we prevent or how many lives we save. And so, if you know anybody, feel free to tell them to call our office. You're welcome to pick up a voucher. If you know anybody who needs an attorney, feel free to give them one of our books. And if you know a law firm, if you know a lawyer, if you have your own lawyer, or you have a lawyer that's a friend who wants to get involved, tell them to call us, and we'll tell them about the ambassador program and how they get involved. We go to churches, we go to YMCAs, we go to health fairs, we go out in the community to spread this message. Now, I can tell you this. I've been on this quest for preventing traumatic brain injury since 1999. We have a web page, we publish books, we give out tens of thousands of helmets for parades. You know what? I bet that there's people in this room that have never heard of providing helmets. We call them car helmets. Providing helmets for children in cars. Now, if your child needs a helmet, and by the way, we have infant helmets, infant-sized helmets too. If your child is going to be on a skateboard or a bicycle, we don't care. They don't have to be in the seat. We're just trying to educate people about the injuries in cars. But if you go Google right now, you'll find other agencies, other attorneys. This is the next big thing.
He wants to wear his helmet.
Ooh, he didn't like that one. So. Put my helmet on. like you did. See, you scared me. And so, you know, if you know any churches or events or anything like that, we're happy to attend and do just exactly what we're doing here. But if you go Google, you'll find all these organizations, and they always have a bike safety, which is coming up, bike safety month. They have bike safety, and they do helmets for kids, but you don't see them promoting helmets for anything else. And like I mentioned in the big room, baseball, football, karate, you know, bicycles. People recognize and they accept that when children are in dangerous activities, well, a bicycle is minor sometimes compared to a car accident. But anyway, that's basically our message. I wanted to be able to answer any questions if anybody had any. I would just, only thing we would ask in return for all the volunteers, the things that we give away, and of course we have some Justice for Children's hats back there that you can help promote, and then our law firm gives out things as well. And I'm told, I've criticized my staff when they started picking out, you know, the chip clips and the koozies and the pins and all that. But the one that surprised me the most, and they tell me you just can't get a good floss water anymore. Some of the schools won't let me bring them because apparently somebody came up with a floss water fight. I think if you're wearing a helmet, it's okay.
Yeah, right.
But anyway, if like I said, if you know any, you know, we have involvement with police officers. We have involvement. We provide magnets for them to give out that have non-emergency police numbers. Because people don't realize they get angry when 911 doesn't get there. But sometimes the reason 911 doesn't get in there fast enough is because people are calling them like, I'm cooking a turkey today. What temperature do I cook it on? And so we post the non-emergency police number on magnets for people to put on refrigerators so that they're not calling 911 and clogging it up. And so we're doing that. We're working now. We're getting all the local law enforcement agencies, and we're going to work across the state. We've been for 7 years in Savannah. Savannah police really like them. Does anybody have any questions about the helmets or the safety or any of the things? I must have covered it all. Well, whatever credit y'all get from Parent University, y'all get credit for the class. So thank y'all so much for taking the time to listen, and I hope that if there's anything we can do for y'all at any level, just let us know. Thank you.